Member types define the structure and content of a member's profile from the member section of the back office of Umbraco. This content can be customized by adding properties to the member type from the settings section. Properties specify data fields and attributes that a member can have, such as name, email, and other relevant information. My name is Alina, and in this video, I will walk you through the process of adding member type properties to customize the member's profile from the back office of Umbraco. Before starting, you will need to have an Umbraco project, preferably on the latest version. And as we will not cover what members are, please watch the video called Members in Umbraco Adding a Member. Alright, so here I have an empty installation of Umbraco on the latest version. So now if I go to the member section and expand the members folder, I can see a member and all members. So this member is the default member type that comes with every installation of Umbraco. So if you create a member, let's call it John Doe. We give it a login and email and a password. We leave the rest as they are, and then we save. Now if we go to the settings section and we expand the member types, we can see that we have a member type called member. If we look at what properties it has, we can see that it has comments. If we go back to members, we can see that it has comments as well. In the member tab, these are the default properties that are stored in the database in the tables member and two-factor login, and they cannot be changed. So let's see how we can create a new member type. We go back to the settings section, member type, and then right-click, create, and then let's call this one premium. Here we can add compositions. Compositions are a way to reuse sets of properties from the already existing member types. Here we can choose the member type that already exists. And as we can see in the background, we have inherited the properties from member. Let's add a new tab and call this one member photo. Then we can add a new property and we can call this one profile picture. Then we select the editor image cropper. We leave the rest as they are. However, as we can see, we have some further options where we can allow this property value to be displayed on the member profile page. We can also allow the members to edit this property value. And we can also enable sensitive data so that the content editors don't have access to view the sensitive information. But I will just leave everything as they are and submit and save. So now we can see that this tab is called generic. However, we can change the name of the tab from the member type. Let's call this membership. And then if we go back to premium, we can see that it has inherited the tab from the member. This is because we are using the composition. Great, so now I have created a new member tab called premium. Now let's see how it looks on the members section. So if I go to all members, create, now I have the option to create a premium member. However, if it doesn't show, you might need to refresh your browser. So let's create a premium member and we will call this one Dojon. Now I can add a picture, which I already have saved one right here. I can also add some comments, but I will just skip this one. And I will give it a login. And a password. And I will leave the rest as it is. Then I can go back to all members to see an overview of all the members, or I can go directly to the premium or the member. You can now create new member types and add properties to customize the member's profile from the member section of Umbraco. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more videos on this channel.